Eating is an integral part of our lives. It plays an important role in our physical, emotional, and social well-being. But the ability to grow that food and receive a sustainable income can play an equally or even more important role in the lives of the farmers who we depend on for it.
Smallholder cocoa farmers are some of the poorest people in the world. They earn less than $400 a year from their cocoa crop, and it means that they aren't earning enough to sustain themselves and their families. This is a problem for all of us, though, because smallholder farmers are probably responsible for delivering 70% of the world's food, so we're relying on them for the food that we eat.
Many farmers worldwide are making efforts to change that paradigm, as a group of cocoa farmers in Ghana did in the early 90s, with the support of a fair trade group and the goals of running a successful organization that empowered farmers, increased women's participation, and developed sustainable cocoa cultivation. They set up a cooperative called Kwapa Cocoa.
The farmers organised themselves at a village level, and they were first of all in 22 villages, and they elected their local executive, and they had instituted quotas for women, so you had to have 2 out of 5 women on the executive, and they very quickly developed a reputation for being honest and efficient. And I think the best way to illustrate that is that they bought weighing scales so farmers could finally trust the transaction.
As Kwapa Cocoa began to thrive, they decided to expand beyond the sale of cocoa and create the first fair trade chocolate bar aimed at the mass market. They recognized the real value in cocoa went beyond the crop itself. There was value in the marketing of the final product, the chocolate. That's when Sophie Tranchell came on board.
Joining a company that was owned by cocoa farmers was an amazing opportunity for me, because everybody loves chocolate, so it's a perfect way to open the conversation about, have you thought about where this product comes from? Have you thought about the people that work to grow the cocoa? And then the idea that you had such a fabulous brand name as Divine, and you had a wonderful range of chocolates, and it was owned by cocoa farmers, it was just an irresistible combination.
Fair trade is important because it gives consumers a chance to vote with their wallet on how they want to see businesses run, such as paying farmers a living wage and making sure that their environmental practices are upheld.
A growing demand for fair trade products and owning their own premium chocolate company has helped Kwapa Cocoa become the biggest cocoa farmers cooperative in the world. And that success has had a huge impact on the lives of its members.
Kwapa Cocoa farmers own 44% of the company, and for that they have 2 seats on the board, which means that they have a say in how the company is run, they have full transparency or about all the decisions in the company, but they also get 44% of any of the distributed profits, which obviously really helps them in terms of their economic stability. Some of the other impacts that working with Divine has had is that they've really been able to make good on their commitment to women's empowerment. And so we've supported them in that. We've invited women over to America and over to Britain to speak for themselves. And those women have become ambassadors in their communities. And in 2006, they elected more women than men onto their national executive. And in 2010, they elected their first woman president. And in 2014, their second woman president. And that means that a woman is the head of a farmers cooperative, which grows 48,000 tons of cocoa, which is more than 1.5% of the world's cocoa. So I think that's pretty amazing.
For consumers, choosing products with the Fair Trade certification label or from social enterprises that are going beyond fair trade can be a powerful endorsement for change.
Being a socially responsible company is not just about making a lot of money that you can give away later on. There are so many opportunities to have business models that integrate positive impact along the way.
Of course, when it comes to consumers, quality matters too.
At the end of the day, the chocolate is selling because it's good chocolate. And that's the entry level, and buyers making decisions on whether or not to put you on the shelf.
Divine chocolate is made with the best natural ingredients. But Divine chocolate is more than delicious. It is 100% fair trade and 44% owned by the farmers who grow the cocoa. So when you enjoy the chocolate, so do the family farmers who grow it.
We deliver 4 income streams for the cocoa farmers. We pay a guaranteed fair trade minimum price. We pay a $200 a ton social premium, which the important thing about that is they get to decide how they spend that money. We invest 2% of our turnover in projects that's recognising that if you're going to work with remote and rural communities, they need all sorts of assistance to help them run their business. So we've helped them on training in agricultural practices, in being a co-op, in developing their own database. And then the 4th income stream is the profit income stream. Because they own 44% of the company, they get 44% any of the distributed profits.
Working for Divine Chocolate is quite different. I find it more meaningful that I'm able to impact the lives of farmers in Ghana.
Divine Chocolate is proud to be a certified B Corporation. B Corporations are leading the global movement of using business as a force for good. As a B Corp, Divine aims to achieve social and environmental goals through practices, products, and profits. You can be a force for good, too, when you support B Corp and fair trade companies.
Divine becoming a profitable company is really exciting. It proves that a business model like this can work, that fair trade, consumer choice, and farmer ownership can all result in a profitable company.
I passionately believe that we can make the world a better place by being discerning about the goods and services that we buy. And Divine wouldn't be here today if consumers hadn't made a nuisance of themselves and gone into shops and asked for products that aren't there. Those people used the power of their consumption to make the world a better place.
Discover the great taste of Divine Chocolate. You can find it in many stores or shop online at divinechocolate.com.